thanks a lot, Karan, for joining me in this chat that we are having. Can you tell me something about Inside Edge and the process of getting the filming of the cricket matches right? What went into it?
Yeah, sure, Chandresh. So, very early on while writing it itself, we wanted to, try to recreate the cricket to be as close as possible to the real thing. And the only way that I think people experience cricket is through, broadcast television. And what I think films do is they end up shooting cricket or any sport, like especially like I found like all the films that had been shot on cricket so far to be shot in a cinematic way, right, with film cameras, etc. And that takes away from the experience that the viewers used to while consuming cricket, live cricket. So we wanted to just align that a little bit, and so we broke it up into two parts. One was the shooting the cricket with actual cricket cameras and have the same sort of coverage which you would find in a real cricket game. So we got some of the producers who are involved with the actual tournaments and had them sort of set it up and shoot, and we shot in real stadiums and things. So that was one aspect of it. To go with that, you've got to have good players also. So we actually got good actual real players to fill up the, like, make up the numbers. They were all state level Ranji players, etc. And our own guys, the actors, trained for a long time under reputed coaches to get to the point where even when they're batting and bowling and things, they sort of look authentic, like they're shots. So it was a combination of using actual setup and cameras, up to like 8, 9, 10 cameras maybe. Of course, actual cricket matches have even more, but we had a very restricted budget. It was a combination of that with good players and real players. And of course, we shot in empty stadiums and then we VFX the crowd in. And I think the VFX quality was good enough that it, it carried through. So it was basically this. Of course, the drama portions, when the players are talking to each other, etc., in the middle of the field, that we shifted to using, film cameras and film lenses to set that apart from the actual coverage stuff that's happening. And there's a pattern that we're following, if you see. Like, there'll be, everything looks like broadcast cricket, except the bits that are, where something's happening behind the scenes that you don't see. So that has a very different sort of feel to it.
That's interesting. And so this Inside Edge, I'm assuming that because you're a big cricket lover, you came up with this idea. But like I was telling you before we started, the detailing of the match shots, and also the fact that you got the dynamics of a franchise very well, especially the team dynamics, especially the different kinds of players. I'm sure that you must have done deep research in how a team dynamic works, because I was involved with the team and I was amazed at the kind of detailing you got right with this whole process. Tell us something about that as well.
Yeah, of course, there was a lot of research. We spoke to a lot of players. We spoke to rookies. We spoke to, team CEOs and people who are involved in the day-to-day activity. But what emerged was a picture that sort of was fragmented, and we had a lot of gaps to fill in. Plus, we took anecdotes, we took real-life instances. All the writers are actually cricket fans in a way, and we all watch our cricket. So we were really committed to it in that sense. We wanted to get it right. And I felt like from my research, interestingly, that the truth and the real aspects are so out there that I actually had to dilute a lot of the crazy, scandalous stuff to make it believable. So that was also, like an issue that we had to deal with. Which was the problem of having too many fun things that we couldn't really, to make it palatable for the viewer. Having said that, I think this applies not only to cricket, but any kind of writing. So I think, writers often get, I mean, there's a lot of underestimation in terms of the kind of research we do into what and we put out. In fact, anyone who gets deeply into any subject will end up looking like someone who knows, who can predict stuff. You know, like even right now, we're sitting in this lockdown and this whole coronavirus situation. But there was a book that came out in 1981, which is with a, I don't know, Wuhan 400 virus that originated in China as a bioweapon, etc. So, I mean, and people are like, oh, look at that. I just feel that if you just, you know, research anything deeply enough, especially writers, because they're physically writing things and every word they write has to be like research, reference, cross-check. That goes a long way in sort of making it very believable and true to life.
Were you shocked at the by your research, as in to look at the kind of how scandalous it could be?
I wouldn't say shocked. I guess I was already shocked enough to want to make this in the first place. And one of the main reasons we got into this was, I'm a bit of a purist. Like, I love test cricket. I'll watch every ball of every test match where India is touring, like overseas, especially if it's like a South Africa, Australia, England sort of situation. I will do that, but I will not necessarily watch, you know, a local T20 tournament. That for me is what the corruption of the game is. And I feel that through this show is what that was the point of it. Like, trying to show the hypocrisy and the behind the scenes in terms of how it's no longer sport and it's more entertainment now. That was essentially what one was trying to highlight. Of course, there are many, many good things that also come out of T20 and franchise cricket. So we've tried to highlight some of that and try to sort of balance that too. But overall, I just feel that it just went off in some weird entertainment direction, yeah. And for, you know, someone who grew up watching cricket and idolizing cricketers, it was a bit of a fall for grace, yeah.
So what's the one good thing that you have learned from the research and from the two seasons of Inside Edge?
What is the one thing I've learned?
One good thing.
About what?
About cricket, about research and about whatever you've done from the show. One good thing that you've learned and you said that, okay, fine, cricket is still, this part of cricket is still good. And you have not turned a city.
I'll have to really think about that. I mean, I can't really think of any positives that have come out for me. I guess I feel happy for the exposure a lot of talent is getting, which I think was extremely curtailed in many ways earlier, because it was about 11 guys making through a team, and of course there were Ranji teams and things, but our domestic structure, I don't think, supported the, you know, pure talent shining through. There was too many other strings attached, and I think that I figured has become a lot more easier if you're just purely talented and don't have, you know, other resources or ways to get into teams at a more local level. That, and I think, you know, like women's cricket and just sort of expanding the game to more spheres, that and reaching out to a larger audience, I think that has helped.
And I'm sure everybody's reached out to you to understand whose character, who is Richa Chadda based on, who is Vivek Oberoi based on. There's a lot of conjecture. People have called me and asked, kya ye uske jaisa hai, kya ye uske jaisi hai. Have you had calls as well from people to say, have you based it on that particular person, this particular person?
Of course, we keep getting that. But, you know, I don't, I say the same thing every time. It's just like, yes, all characters in any show or film that you see is an amalgamation of various aspects of various people. And it's the same here. It's just that because they're so, that you've seen them so much more and they're so much more relatable, that you feel like, okay, this guy must be this guy. But it's not that, because there are so many aspects of every character that we've tried to build that draw from multiple sources. And they don't all have to be cricketers or team owners, you know. You'll definitely find shades of some, you know, like, I don't know, a Virat Kohli, a Vayu Raghavan, But that's not the only aspect about him. There's he's got many other things which we borrow from other places. I know there's a Ben Stokes moment with him in the second season, and there's some other moment with him from drawing from other people in this, you know, in a different episode. So it's not one person. It's not ever one person, and that applies to any kind of character that you build as you write.
And in terms of your casting, was having played some kind of cricket an added advantage, say for someone like you played Vayu Raghavan, say Tanuj Virwani, having played a bit of cricket, and for the others as well, was that an advantage that came good for them?
It was a requirement. I mean, you can't cast a star batsman and not have him, you know how to hold a bat, for Christ's sake. So that was an absolute requirement, especially like I think in Zidane's case, to be a bowler. I'd seen him, he'd auditioned, and I met him, and then we were shooting something else, and I was like, you know, just show me your bowling action, man, because we gotta figure that stuff out. We gotta do that right. Even with Tanuj, I know he used to play cricket. We used to play cricket together at some point. I'm not that he was necessarily very good, but the moment we got into this, at least I knew he had a great interest in the game, and I knew he had clean strokes. And once we cast, then he got into proper training, and now he's like, you know, 5,000 times better than I ever was. So, but at one time we were like almost like competing with each other. So that obviously was a requirement going in for the casting.
And there are two interesting things that I noticed. One was a female analyst, which England had, which is Stuart Broad's sister. And the other one was the bowling coach. That was also an interesting, Vidya Malavade as the bowling coach for one of the teams in the second season. How did that come about?
No, but look, for me, Inside Edge is not about, cricket. It's not only about cricket. It's also about human emotion and failing and etc. So it's, I didn't want this to become like a testosterone-driven guy show. I think all the writers were very much in agreement with that. And we wanted to get very empowered, good female characters right from season one. So whether it's, Meera, who was Vayu's girlfriend, or Rohini, who's the analyst, played by Shavani, or Zarina, Richard's character, they all are the ones who make things happen. They're the ones who are the prime movers and, you know, decision makers. They're not there propping the men up. And that is something we are very cautious about while writing a show that is essentially about a game that is, you know, driven by men. So wherever we could, we got, you know, female protagonists to sort of come in and do their thing. And really pushing that boundary with Vidya's character as a bowling coach in the second season. And in a way, I think we want to even give ideas to people, you know, like, why aren't there more bowling coaches? Because as a coach, you're not supposed to go and actually, you know, you've got to understand the game. You've got to understand the technique more than actually having to bowl to these guys, right? So it's, and same with analysts. They don't have, we're trying to break stereotypes and introduce ideas. That's something we always try to showcase stuff that, we hope that will turn into trends later, whether it is, you know, just having better kits, for example, like the design of that, to, you know, actually having women play important bits in cricket.
Also the interesting thing was moving the league abroad, just like it happened in 2009.
Yeah.
So there are lots of interesting correlations. Were you worried at any point that there will be a lot of comparisons and about whether it is truly completely inspired by the real life version, or were you okay with the whole thing?
No. I mean, you have to see the similarities. We have many, many moments like that. Like, for example, when moving the tournament abroad in our second season compared to the other one, which was also moved in a second season, right? 2009. Then small things like Vayu writing fuck it on his back. Was it Brad Haddin or right? Yeah. And so there are little things like this which any cricket enthusiast, and of course we work that into the story in a big way, and we say, okay, so at that time this guy did this, or the tournament was moved, but what could have been the reason? Then that's where the drama and the fiction and the speculation sort of kicks in. Over here you have a home minister wanting a team. How much of that is fiction and things? But we're just going with that. But we want the fun of spotting something that you know has happened and seeing it in a show. That's an unparalleled high for any viewer.
And is there going to be a season 3? And will the story expand beyond the league? What's the future for the show? I don't want to give me the inside details. If you can just tell me if there's going to be a season 3.
Mostly.
That's interesting. And have you had interesting calls from the cricketing ecosystem to say that
whoever's called has really liked it. So and these are like mainstream players, who are there in the Indian team and in other teams. So we've got some, and a lot of times they're like, we watch it, it's great, and things. Obviously we can't tweet about it. A whole bunch of them have actually gone and tweeted about it also. We had even Virendra Sehwag sort of promoting it this time. So was Yuvraj, and I think Murali Karthik is a big fan. So we've had these guys are publicly like sort of associated, not associated, but have liked the show. And the other guys, well, I can't really name them.
And last couple of questions. I just wanted to know, in terms of cricketing web series and cricketing documentaries or shows like that, which of the shows do you watch? Did you watch the test which came out on?
I absolutely love the test. I mean, for me, like watching anything on cricket that's actually well made, that's it's superb, and I really enjoy watching all kinds of sports movies, and I enjoy sports generally, like even participating, playing, making stuff on it. I really enjoy the test. Again, with the test, it was so interesting because you know what happened, you know what went down, and to sort of see the behind the scenes. In a way, this is what Inside Edge is about, but this was a little more pure and more, it was about all things good that is happening with cricket, and especially with the Australian cricket team. I remember when Smith and Warner went down, and it was so disappointing and shocking, and for someone, I guess the Australians got to a point where they sort of asked for it in a way. There was a culture problem over there, which is what the test is about and how they went about changing it. And, a lot of people come to me and say, India winning their first series in Australia for me, which is covered in the test again, was like one of the finest moments, right? Like for any cricket fan, like Indian team fan. And I was so happy and thrilled. And, you get this nonsense from people saying, oh, but it was a depleted Australian side, etc. But isn't Australia responsible to have gotten to that point in the first place where they dug that hole for themselves, where they could not sustain a winning habit without getting to a point where they were literally cheating? Yeah. So I don't agree with that. And I think we had a very legit victory. I don't mind the way the test portrayed the Indian cricket team and Virat Kohli in particular. I'm a big fan of Kohli. And, what happened was I loved it. And it may not have... it was good.
Any show or series that you would recommend everybody to watch, sports or cricket especially, that you would recommend?
Sports series, I would definitely recommend the test if you're into cricket. But besides that, I think another great one is F1, the F1 show, what's it called? The Drive to Survive. Yeah, F1 Drive to Survive. The last two years, seasons have been covered in one season each, and it's wonderful. I mean, that's what you want. You know, F1 is also such an inaccessible sport for everyone because you're just watching these guys go on a track. And what's happening behind the scenes, I mean, unless you're really into it and you're like, looking up all the blogs and this and that, and that's something I used to do with F1. This is like such unrestricted access into everything from their design and centers to, you know, getting on the track and behind the pit wall, what's going on. It was such a high. I loved it.
And finally, is it fair to call you the showrunner of Inside Edge? And can you explain what is the term showrunner? Because not everybody who's not involved in the space.
Yeah, I get that. Yeah, I am the showrunner of Inside Edge. It basically means, how you have the director as the captain of the ship in a film. It's the showrunner in a show / series. And it's basically someone who has a final sort of call on the writing and, you know, the final cut of the show, basically.
Okay. And one final thing, apart from Inside Edge, will we see any of your other sports, non-sports product on air anytime soon?
Yes, maybe not anytime soon, but working on a bunch of interesting things. Sports, I am trying to wing something right now. If it happens, it'll be a great fun thing, but that's also cricket. And there's another sport and another project, but it's too early to talk about anything. So
thanks a lot, Karan, for sparing some time to speak to me. It was great chatting with you.
Anytime.
Thank you.